रिकॉर्ड, लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन। Right, okay guys, any issues, any doubts? Okay, so the job step is going to change.
Sir, give me record permission, sir. Mahesh.
Yeah, Mahesh. Okay. Shashi, sir, what is your question? Yes, yes, yes. So, Shanmukh, on which case we need to change the type, script type? Which case we will change? Tell me first. Which case we will change the script? Say, customer asked you to create a restore job. You will use the same script?
As per requirement, we will change the script, sir.
Right, as per the requirement, we'll change. Customer asked to create a DBCC check DB job. Okay, we will give the same script.
No, sir.
As per this customer requirement, we'll change the script. If he's asking backup job, we'll give backup script. If he's asking restore job, we'll give restore script. If he's asking different job, we'll give different script. If it is application specific jobs, they are going to give the scripts. We'll simply run that script automatically. It will create the job. Nothing to worry about the script and all. Okay. So each job will have its own script. You have to run that script automatically. It will create the job. Even DBA related job scripts also, scripts will be there. As discussed, we'll have 5 DBA jobs, right? Backup job,
yes, sir.
Full backup job, differential mm-hmm. backup job, log backup job. Okay. Apart from this DBCC check DB job, DB rebuild index, reorganize index, okay, update statistics. All these jobs will have scripts. Direct whole script will be not only for this, okay, not only this script, not this script. The whole script will be there to create the job itself with the schedule, everything, whatever I'm selecting now, everything will be included in the schedule, in the script also. Simply you will copy that job, might be sometimes you have to change the server name and you will execute it. That's it. Each job will have its own script. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay, fine.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Yeah. So this step, after this step is completed, if this is the only step in the job, you can simply, no need to change any options here. Simply you can keep it as it is. Okay. Means if the job is successful, it will report, it will quit the job saying the job is successful. If the job is failure, means if the job is failed due to other reasons, it will quit the job saying the job is failed. That's it.
Yes.
If you have extra requirements, after this job, it has to do this thing. Say, for example, restoring, guys. Restoring, we will have a common practice. Okay, before restore, what people is going to do usually, first, they will keep the database offline. Okay, why? Because sometimes a restore won't be done if any active connections are there from the database. Imagine you are restoring a production database into non-prod server. Imagine, okay? So non-prod server, already some users connected to the database, they are working on it. Okay, imagine. If anyone is working on the database, what usually we are going to do, we are going to overwrite the database. Sometimes we are going to overwrite the database if the database is already existed. So sometimes we are going to overwrite the database, right? Fine. So while doing that overwrite, option is there, right?
Right, sir.
Yes. Okay. sometimes we are going to, as discussed, sometimes we are going to overwrite the database, right? So if any connections are there from the database, you cannot overwrite the database. If someone is using, simply if anyone is using the notepad, can you delete the notepad or file?
No, sir.
No, right? What we'll do? We'll close it.
We need to, yes, sir.
We will close the notepad and we are going to delete it. In the same way, if you are restoring a database, if anyone is using the same database, it's not possible to overwrite the database. So what we will do? We have to keep the database offline manually before restoring, not after restoring. Before restoring, we'll keep the database offline manually and then we'll restore the database, right? That can be achieved in two steps. Step one, you can write a script to keep the database offline. Alter database, database name, set offline with rollback immediate. That is the query. Once step one is successful, then it will go to step two, guys. What is the step two? It is a restore script. So in this way, the steps will be there. Not only this, this is just for example we are discussing. This is just for example. If it is restore step, restore job, then it will be like this. Once step one is successful, once the job kept the database offline, then step two is executed. It is going to go to the next step, that is a restore the database. If you write the same script directly without keeping the database offline, that job might be failed. Why? Because already people are there, they are accessing this database, so it cannot overwrite the database. As people are accessing, database can't overwrite the database. It cannot delete it. Clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts? This is just for example, I'm saying. So multiple steps will be there, depends upon the requirements. Sometimes jobs will be like this, okay? So in only one job, all the requirements will be there. Maintenance jobs, okay? First, it will take the backup of all the databases. Second step, it will run DBCC checkDB job. Third, it is going to run, as discussed, okay, rebuild index, third step. Fourth step, in case, depends upon the rebuild index or reorganize index, it is going to work. Fourth step, like fifth step, okay, we will have update statistics. So sometimes, very rarely, that is not a good practice, but very rarely, they will include all the steps in the same job itself. 99% they will create different jobs for different requirements. But sometimes, very rarely, you can find like this. Clear? Is it clear? So simply, if one step is successful, then if you have any other requirement, it will go to the next step. Again, next step, you have to create it. I gave you an example, right? Keeping you want to restore one database. If you want to restore a database, first of all, you have to overwrite the database. Okay. If you want to overwrite the database, if anyone is using the database, you cannot keep the database. Okay. You cannot overwrite the database. So first step, we'll bring the database offline. First step. Once first step is successful, then it will go to the next step. Then it is going to restore the database. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Everyone. So steps are your requirements, depends upon your requirements. If it is a backup job and all, 99% one step will be there. Okay. In that one step, you can see the script. What is the script for taking the backup? That script will be included. If it is restore job and all, you can see multiple steps. Once that, say for example, this is like this. Step one, it is going to keep the database offline. Step two, it will restore one database. Once it is successful, it will restore another database. Once it is successful, it will restore another database. Like it is going to restore one by one database. Each database restore is one step. Once that step is successful, it will restore the next database. Clear, guys? Now, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, depends upon your requirement. Okay, you will have multiple steps in the jobs. I'm not saying for every job we'll have multiple steps. Depends upon your requirement. Some jobs might have only one step. If your requirement is fulfilling in one step, only one step will be there in the job. If your requirement is there, like you have to restore multiple databases, you can create a different step for each database. Okay, guys. So depends upon the requirements, you will have multiple steps also. So if you have multiple steps, so for example, if step one is successful, even though you have multiple steps, guys, simply step one, you just mention like this, quit the job reporting. So you have 10 steps. You have 10 steps. After step one, those 10 steps has to be run. But someone changed the setting like this. Once step one is successful, quit the job reporting success. Then tell me what is the impact. Other jobs, other steps are going to run, or simply the job will quit. Tell me, guys. You have 10 steps in the job.
Yes.
Okay. So first step, after first step, it has to go to the next step. But someone changed the script, the step settings like this. After first step, it has to, once the first step is successful, it has to quit the job reporting as success. Now tell me other steps. If this is your settings, now tell me other steps are going to run or it won't run.
No, sir, it will not work, sir.
Why it won't work?
Because the we have said here, after the first step, the job will quit and the reporting success, sir.
If first step is successful, it will simply quit it. It won't touch other steps. Yes. If it has to touch other steps, we'll select this option, go to next step. Once step one is successful, it will go to the next step. Once that is also successful, it will go to the next step. If step two is having a next step, step three, then you have to select go to next step. Okay, if it is failed, okay, this is success action. If the job is successful, it has to go to next step. Okay, chalo. When it has to go to next step, if you have next steps, then only it has to go to next step. If you have only one step, what is the use of selecting this option? There is no use, right? Simply you can select quit the job reporting success. If it is failed, quit the job reporting as failure. Even though your job is failed, you have five steps, guys. First step, after first step is successful, it has to go to the next step, right? But if there is no dependency on first step, if the first step is failed, either you can go to select next step, or simply you can select with the job reporting failure, success, not success, failure. Clear, guys? If there is a dependency on the steps, for example, step two is depending on step one, then you have to select this option, quit the job reporting failure. There are no dependencies. Step two is not depending on step one. Then simply you can select go to next step. Okay, step one is failed, no problem. Chalo, go to next step, execute the next steps. Clear, guys? When we have to select go to next step, when we have to select quit the job reporting success failure. Is it clear? Simply it's just common sense. If you have next steps, other steps are there, you will choose each job, each step you will choose go to next step. If that is the last step, you can choose quit the job reporting success. Or if only one step is there, you can choose quit the job reporting success. Clear, guys, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anyone having any doubts, let me know, no problem.
Sir, we have many databases in server, sir.
Yes.
Then what about job, sir? Is
that's
there
what I told you. That's what I told you. If I have 100 databases, don't expect 100 jobs. In one step itself, you can take the backup of all the databases. Okay.
But it is different for instances, sir.
That is different for instance. See, that's correct question. Okay. Each instance will have full backup job. Okay. So the job cannot take backup of other instances. It will take care of that instance only. If you have 100 instances, 100 full backup jobs will be there. In each instance, one full backup job. Okay. Clear, guys? Okay. Any doubts? Okay. So here you can see retry attempts, retry intervals and all. See, in case for the first time, if your job is failed, if you mention retry attempts as 2, okay? And if you gave it 5 minutes each interval, What happened, case? Can anyone explain me this 2 and 5 settings? Can anyone explain me this 2 and 5, what it will do?
Sir, retry attempts means it attempts 2 times, sir.
Very good. It will attempt 2 times. Very good.
Next, retry interval means for each retry attempt, it takes 5 minutes.
Very good. Excellent. If your step 1 is failed, guys.
Yes.
Okay, if you mention like this, if it is failed only, if it is successful, it won't retry. When it is going to retry, if it is failed only. If your step 1 is failed, you mention settings like this, then it will try for 2 times. In 5 minutes interval, 10 o'clock your job is failed. Then again 10:05 the step will run. The same step will run. If 10:05 also job is failed, then again in a 5 minutes interval, 10:10 next time also it will run. That's it. 2 retry attempts are completed. Then it will go to the next step. Clear, guys? If you see values like this, make sure those are retry attempts and retry intervals. Okay, nothing. So you can click OK. That's it. Okay. So step 1 is completed. Okay, right? Schedules. This is very important. So you just write a proper code. Everything looks good. You give proper name, database owner and all. Everything is fine. But if you haven't enabled the schedule, what is the use of this job? Right? You just mention, see, alarm, while keeping alarm, what we will do, we'll select the date, we'll select the time, we'll select AM or PM. Everything we are going to select. But if we turn off the alarm, what is the use of the alarm? Right? So in the same way, you give proper step name, you give proper script and all, everything is very good. But you haven't set the schedule, then this is not going to schedule. It is not going to run. Okay, so you have to create schedule also. Again, same. Click on schedules, go to new, select new option. Now you have to give the schedule. I'll give the name as full backup job schedule. _SCH. Okay, this has to be recurring job, guys. Okay, recurring means what? It has to repeat, right? So we'll have a lot of options. Start automatically when SQL Server agent start whenever CPU becomes idle, recurring, one time. Why we have to create this much of job and all? Simply you can run the script at one time, right? So it should be recurring only. The job should be recurring only. Recurring means repeat. It is going to repeat. Now you can mention here, you want weekly jobs, you want daily jobs, you want monthly jobs. How you want? What is the frequency? If it is weekly, okay, chalo, no problem, weekly. Then weekly once or every day, what is your schedule? You have to mention here. Every day I want to take, then select all the days. No, weekly once I want to take. Then on what day you want to take? Sunday, Saturday, which day you want to run this job? Make sure that that day is selected. Okay, chalo, weekly once, okay. Weekly once, okay, that's fine. At what time? Weekly once, you are going to select weekly once at what day? Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. What day you want to run this job, you are going to select it. Right, Sunday, you just selected Sunday. Okay, Sunday at what time you want me to run this job? Okay, you can mention here. Occurs only one time. Then you can mention at what time you want to run this job. Or else Sunday occurs every 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, then you can mention this job. You can change the schedule. Occurs once at, imagine I want to schedule my job as 2 o'clock, early morning 2 o'clock. Okay, so now this job, see here, occurs every week on Sunday at 2 a.m. Schedule will be used starting today onwards. Simply, nothing is there. Simply, what day you want, at what time you want, that's you are going to choose. That's it. I want to run this job every 15 minutes. Okay. Imagine this is a log backup job. Log backup job, it has to run for every 15 minutes, right? So now how you are going to schedule this one? You are going to change this to daily. Daily, reoccurs every one day, that's fine. Occurs once is not going to, we are not going to choose this option. Occurs every 15 minutes. 15, here we are going to change it to minutes. Occurs every day, every 15 minutes, between 12 a.m. to, between night 12 to, again night 12. This is how you are going to take the log backup. This is the schedule for the log backup. It's not log backup, guys. It's a full backup. We gave full backup query. If it is a log backup, you will give log backup and you will change the schedule like this. You are going to mention, I want to schedule the log backup job for every 15 minutes. This is how you are going to do that. Okay, you are going to select occurs every 15 minutes. The frequency is daily. Daily occurs every 15 minutes. If you are taking full backup weekly, you will choose weekly. And weekly at what day? Sunday. At what time on Sunday? You will mention either. Okay. Whatever time you want depends upon their requirement, we mentioned the time. Clear, guys? Nothing is there. Simple. It's very simple. Click OK. Okay. So remaining all are different things, guys. Notifications. For example, if this job is failed, we have to get an email. So you can mention this also. Once this job is failed, the DBA team has to get an email. So for that, you have to go for extra settings. Okay, database mail option is there. If you just configure database mail properly, then if this job is failed, if you choose email option, it will ask the account name, operator name. Once you choose the particular operator name, automatically it will send an email when the job fails. When the job fails, automatically you will get an email to your Outlook itself. Clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts as of now? That's it. We gave all the details. You can click OK. Done. Your backup job is completed. It's just created. You can see here. Okay. Full backup job.
And if you go to backup of one database.
Yes. Just backup of one database. It's just backup of one database. It won't touch other databases and all. And if you see here, program files, Microsoft SQL Server, and instance root directory and MS SQL and backup. Yeah, see, it won't work. It won't work, Sashi. Why? Because you have to first create database mail for that. Okay, database mail. Once you configure database mail, then only you can give your email ID. Database mail, what happened is it's not working properly. So we have to go for extra settings. Usually in the organization, we'll have separate mail server. Separate mail server will be there. We are going to use that separate mail server. But here we have to depends on either Gmail or different accounts and all. But I tried. As you don't have like separate mail server, it won't work properly. There are extra settings are needed. I'll show you how to create the database mail. I'm not sure whether it will be successful or not, but I'll show you how to create the database mail. Once you created the database mail, then you can use your Gmail to get the alerts. If this job is failed, directly you will get an alert to your Gmail itself. But in the organization, we'll have separate mail server for that. Separate server will be there. We don't have that separate mail server and all, so it won't be successful sometimes. Okay? Right? Fine. You can see here, right? There is no backups with today's date, 22nd. Date modified is 19th is the last backup. Okay? So let me run the... As per the schedule, it will run... Next Sunday, today is Monday, right? We just scheduled this job for Sunday 2 a.m., right? So when this job will run again, next Sunday 2 a.m. it will run. Of course, we have to wait for the next Sunday. Or else you want to run this job manually. You can run this job manually at any time you want. But in the organization, don't do that. If it is a backup job and all, you cannot run it manually. Why? Because backup jobs will simply configure this backup jobs during weekends, night times and all. Backup jobs are performance killers. Don't run this in case if your backup job is failed. Don't try to run this job during business hours. It will create performance issues. Okay, right. Now, if you want to run the job manually, right click on the job, start job at step. If you have 10 steps, you will get another window, which step you want me to run. If you have only one step, it will automatically start like this. Okay, and now you can see, go to your backup folder. Now you can see backup is generated. Amazon full backup 22/11/2021.bak. You can see the date stamp. You can see the date modified also. Whenever you run, there is a problem with this. Okay. Next time if you run, it will be successful or it will be failed, guys. Tell me. Again, if I run this job, is it going to be successful or it will be failed?
Failed.
Why?
Successful, sir.
Why failed? Any reason?
Sir, we automated to run the job particular time.
Okay.
No, sir. But we have taken right now. We have taken the backup, sir. So we, if we run the job, then it will successful, sir.
Tell me, guys. It will be successful or it will be failed?
Successful, sir.
Okay, so it will be successful. How many times you are going to run? Every time it will be successful only. Why it will be failed? It won't fail at all. It will be successful only. Okay, so but the problem is, as we are not going to override the backup, so it is going to be included. Okay, so yes, now sir. This is appended. Okay, the last backup set and the previous backup set. Just now we ran it, right? That backup set, this backup set will be appended in the same file. Now this file is called media set. Collection of backup sets, you can call it as a media set. Again, if you run it, again, it is going to be successful, but the file size would be 9,000. Every time if you run it, 3,000 will be added. Okay? Clear, guys? So,
yes,
it won't be failed if you run the job, if you have proper, for example, this is a backup job. Imagine in this drive, C drive, I don't have free space. Then it will be failed. Okay. So I don't have free space, but you're asking me to create a backup file, which is 10 GB. I have only 1 GB. In that case, it will be failed. Right. There is no free space, right? It will be failed. So in those scenarios, usually jobs will be failed. Okay. If you don't have permissions, proper permissions, if you don't have enough free space, in those scenarios, usually your jobs are going to be failed. Clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts?
Yes,
sir. So tomorrow I'll give you one assignment. Okay. Very simple assignment. Very easy assignment. Everyone has to try it and let me know the answer. Just Google it. Okay. No need to write the script your own. Script, just type like this only in the Google. Script to take the database backups with the date and time stamp. There is a challenge with this job. Just for explain, just for like to understand, I just created a full backup job, a basic full backup job. But this is not the correct backup job. You know, right? What is the problem with this job? Whenever you run this job, it will append to the existing backup set. Okay, whenever you run this job, it is going to append to the existing backup set. Second one, why? Because it is going to take the file name from the script. But Google it. What is the script to create the database backups with the date and timestamps automatically? Just Google like this only. You will get one script. And by using that script to create one backup job. So tomorrow, create a backup job that has to take backups of all the databases with one script only. With one script, it has to take the backups of all the databases. And dynamically, the date and timestamp has to be included in the particular file name. Everyone, is it clear, guys? Nothing, guys. Just a matter of 5 minutes. It won't take much time. If you are, okay, doing hard work, it's a matter of 2 minutes only. If you are till now, if you are thorough with the SQL Server, if you are good in the SQL Server, it's just a matter of 2 minutes. If you are not practicing, it will take just 5 minutes. I want a script that has to take the backups of all the databases with the date and timestamps. Is it clear, guys? Any issues, any doubts? Okay. Yes. Say, for example, let me do one thing. Let me go to this job. Let me go to the steps. Let me edit this step. Okay. I just edit, I'll edit this step. I'm going to what I can do. I'll just change the script. Okay, this is wrong, right? This is not a correct script, right? I'll keep it okay. Okay, just go for okay and click on okay. Right, now this job is successful or it will be failed, guys? Tell me. If I run this job, it will be failed, right? Why? Because the query is not correct, right? So you can just run this job again. In case if the jobs are failed, wait to check that we are discussing now. Lot of jobs will be failed in the organization, guys. Okay, jobs will be failed, but wait to check how to troubleshoot that we are discussing now.
Sir, go to activity monitor, sir.
Anywhere, from anywhere you can check it. Okay, from here also you can check. No need to go to activity monitor.
Okay, sir.
This job is allotted for only Amazon database, sir.
Yes, only for Amazon database.
So in organization we choose all databases.
Yes. We don't choose it manually. There is a separate script for that. That's why I asked you to check for that script. Google the script and get the script and create a backup job and let me know the result. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sir, in Google it's showing declare file name.
No. Just try it and you can, once you just create a job, then let me know the result, whether it is taking backups of all the databases or not, with the date and timestamps or not. Okay. And show me that output. Once the job is successful, it will generate lot of backups, right? With all the databases, including master, model, every database, right? So show me that output of the backups. It's taking a lot of time. Okay, no problem. We'll wait. Okay, and I'll show you where to check the errors and all. Then we'll close the session for today.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
You are uploading videos on YouTube, sir. Right?
Yes. Only Friday video is pending.
Yes, sir. After some time, it will get deleted, sir.
No. It won't be deleted.
Yes. Sir, you said restore operation on standalone, sir. You also set to on another server also.
Yeah, I'll show you in the migration concept, okay? How to restore database in another server. Nothing major, guys. No big difference and all, okay? Very simple option. There is a second option, file space. There you have to select the relocate files and folders. That's it. Okay, so it's not a different way. Simply, you have to select one extra option if you are restoring database in another server. Okay, I'll show you that one. No problem. In the migration concept, we'll discuss. Okay, why it is taking this much time, guys? It has to simply throw the error. See, this is also one process only, guys. I'm running this job manually, right? In the back end, one process will run. Okay, if you open this and if you can see sp_whodo, you can see all the processes, right? So in the back end, until the job is going to be completed, it is going to, every action is going to run as one process, guys. Every action is going to run as one process. Okay, process you can see, right? sp_whodo, you can see all the processes and all. Okay, now if I run this one sp_whodo, okay, I can see what and all processes are running in my SQL server. Okay, so if you go down, It hasn't been initialized itself. You can see here, there is no backup command, right? If you can see any backup command and all, that means it is initialized. It hasn't been initialized as of now. It is still like taking time. Let me check once. Even though there is no process also, it hasn't been allocated with any process. So to kill the process, let's wait for 2 minutes. If not, we'll go in a different way, okay? Once the job is started, we cannot stop the job. We can kill the job. Okay. That we have to done from sp underscore who to, you will check which session is running, from which session this job is running. Simply you have to kill that session. That's it. There is no stop option. Okay. You cannot stop the job. The only way is you have to kill the session. But as of now, as query is wrong, it hasn't been allocated any session. If the session is allocated, imagine under 59 session, if the backup job is running, then if you just kill the backup job, kill 59, then the job will be stopped. That is how we are going to stop the job. Clear, guys? Interesting. Yeah. If you can close it, if you close this, okay, nothing will happen. Again, the activity monitor, you can see whether it is running or not. Okay, refresh it. Oh, okay, okay, got it. Now, can anyone tell me what is the reason?
Sir, it takes 5 minutes to refresh.
Very good, excellent. You can see here, guys, okay? Full backup job, yes, what is the status between retries? So, first time it was failed, then waited for 5 minutes. Next time it will run. Next time it was, of course, next time also it will fail. Why? Because we gave the incorrect syntax. Again, it will wait for 5 minutes. And it will go to the next step. It will go to the next iteration. Like that, it will wait for 10 minutes. We gave 5 minutes break, right? So 2 times 2 into 5, 10 minutes it will wait. After that, you will get the result, whether it was failed or succeeded. That's why it is taking a lot of time. Okay. Okay. Go to steps, go to backup step, double click on it, go to advanced. Zero. I'm going to change it to 0000. Now I guess it won't take effect. Why? Because it's already initiated with the old step, right? Now go to activity monitor, double click on it. If you refresh, it is showing the law. It is still showing the retry items between retries. No problem. Okay. Let me reconnect. Okay. So that I'll show you the error. Then I'll show you where to check if the jobs are failed, where to check. I'll show you. Then we are going to close the session. Okay. Please reconnect again. Okay.